the view of water, because that's constantly changing and challenging to me. I happened to start to paint in my late 90s. I was born in 1907 on February the 25th. At least that's what I've been told. So I'm going to be 100 next February. I look at the blank canvas and think, what in the heavens am I going to put on this? But then I get going, and it's fun to see the picture evolving. I happen to like landscapes. I did try once to do a portrait of myself, and I carefully eliminated all the wrinkles. My mother, when I was 4 years old, invited me to march in a suffragette parade. She thought that every woman should have the right to vote. I didn't know what I was marching for, but I waved my little yellow flag with enthusiasm. And when she got the right to vote, she and my father did not vote on the same ticket. I was a little surprised to find myself working for a master's and a PhD. I met my husband on a train going from Paris to Geneva, Switzerland. We were both headed to this international school, and I think I started the conversation by asking a very brilliant question. I said to him, "Is Geneva the next stop?" I loved being an ambassador's wife. My husband was a hard worker. He believed in throwing himself with enthusiasm at any job he had to do. Too good.
About there. That's perfect.
Oh no. Every time I get in position, someone comes along and whacks me.
I really should try get rid of Catherine, but.
No, don't try to get rid
That's
of
Catherine.
Oh heck. I'm not gonna be kind to you if you're gonna do that. Oh! Oh, 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 this is painful.
Evil does not pay.
No, meanness doesn't pay. I'm not going to be mean anymore.
Whoa! Whoa!
Oh! You almost wiped me off my feet. That's all right. I forgive you.
I didn't expect it to get that far.
I told you we should have brought shoulder pads and full helmet.
I know. Very fast impressionist, and I get very impatient if it takes me more than 2.5 hours to finish a picture. I may start a new picture this afternoon if I feel inspired. I think I've changed. in my attitude about the world because I'm much more aware of what's wrong than I used to be. The world is going to ruin at the moment. This morning, the newspaper was full of alarming news, full of people trying to destroy whole cities. Any day, we could also be devastated as we were in 9/11. History is repeating itself. Talk more, not to our friends, but to our enemies. And I think through talking and not fighting, we might come to some agreement or agree to disagree and get on anyway. Well, I think to support the international cooperation is very important in every aspect. I just feel that I've been lucky, and I should give back because I've been so lucky. In your youth, you learn. Then in your middle life, you earn. And in your older life, you return. I have 8 grandchildren and 7 great-grands. And I must say that my great-grands seem to be the prizes of the pack.
Thank you, everyone.
I noticed that my little great-grandson couldn't quite get the steps, but he always was there for the jump. Genevieve was very graceful and charming as she was dressed in a sweet little skirt. Cute, adorable. I'm lucky. I enjoy watching my new generation, and I think that when I watch them and their friends, that we have great hope for the future if some madman doesn't do very bad things to this planet. And the sooner we get the young to go along with other people of different colors and religions and understanding of life, the better off we'll be. Maybe a method of stopping war. My 99 years have taught me there will always be conflict. It's part of human nature. But I'll remind you that love, kindness, and support are also part of human nature. My challenge to you is to bring about a mindset of preparing for peace instead of preparing for war. Thank you all for coming, listening, and above all, trying. Let's take advantage of today and be as useful as we can be. I do believe in that.